Assalamu alaikum students, I am Dr. Hawa Batul and the practical today is blood group and Rh factor determination. First of all, the principle that would be followed for this practical is we will determine the blood group of a person by mixing his RBCs with anti-sera. The anti-sera contains agglutinins or antibodies while the sample of the person or RBCs contains antigens. As you can see that RBCs has cell membrane which contains antigens which we call as agglutinogens, whereas the plasma of the blood contains antibodies. We will make both these RBCs and plasma or antisera to react and look for clumping of RBCs or agglutination. Now, what is Landsteiner's law? Landsteiner was a scientist who discovered in 1901 that there are four blood types on the basis of antigens present in RBCs: A, B, AB, and O. A person with blood group A has antigens A, while antibodies anti-A. The person with blood group B has antigens B and antibodies anti-B. A person with blood group AB has both antigens, and a person with blood group O has no antigen present in his blood. Now, the Landsteiner's law states that if an antigen is present on RBC membrane, the corresponding antibody or agglutinin must be absent in the plasma. And if an antigen is absent on the RBC membrane, the corresponding antibody or agglutinin must be present. This second part of law is not applicable for Rh blood group because we have only one antibody, that is anti-D. Now the apparatus that we will be using during this practical is a glass slide, a test tube, droppers, lancet, a marker for labeling, cover slips, microscope and common pins. The reagents are normal slime of 0.9% concentration, antisera A that I will show you in a while, it is of blue color, antisera B which is usually yellow color, and antisera D which is usually transparent. The methodology that we will be using is indirect method. I will be showing you the practical and its demonstration in some while. Let us see that how will we interpret the results of the practical. Here on this side, I have shown you the serum as we have labeled it as A and B, while on this side, the blood type that we will interpret on the basis of agglutination present on the slides. If you see agglutination present on both the sides, the blood group would be AB. As you can see, if you see agglutination present only on B side, the blood group would be labeled as B, while if the slide gave us agglutination on A side, the blood group would be labeled as A. In this case, when no agglutination would be present, the blood group would be labeled as O. Here on this side, Rh blood group determination is shown. Let us see apparatus that we will use during this practical. These are the glass slides. A test tube. Spirit swabs. Clean lancets. Mixing sticks, and the reagents that I will show you one by one. This is Anticera A, which is blue colored. This you can see in a yellow colored bottle is Antiserum B. And this colorless or transparent fluid in the bottle is Antiserum D. Students, now we are going to perform our practical for blood group determination. First of all, you will take a clean slide. And divide it into two halves, A and B, with a marker. Now we will place two drops of Antisera A on area A. And a drop of Antiserum B on area B. You will use separate droppers, as you can see we have done. Now this is the sample that we have got from our subject and we have made it suspension. You will put one drop of suspension, which has the RBCs, on both sides of slide. Now you will mix the antisera and blood with separate pins. We will mix thoroughly so that our reagent is mixed thoroughly with our blood sample. Now we are mixing on B side with another stick. Always remember that you don't have to mix both sides. Now we will wait for 10 to 15 minutes. Now we will inspect this blood mixture for clumping of red blood cells, which we also called as agglutination. Now students, you can see after 15 minutes there is no clumping of cells. For confirmation of clumping, we will put this slide under microscope. And we'll look for any agglutination. The result of this practical, as you can see, is O. The blood group is labeled as O, as no antigens are present in the blood because both antisera have not reacted with the blood sample. Now, for Rh blood group determination, we have taken a new slide. The principle of this experiment would be, we will label this blood group as Rh positive if Rh antigen reacts with Rh antibody and clumping of cells takes place. For this purpose, in the same manner, we will label the slide as D and C by dividing it into two halves. We will take antisera D and put a drop of this serum on side D while leaving other side empty. Now put one drop of RBC suspension on both sides. In the next step, we will take a clean stick and mix our reagent, which is anti-CD, with the blood sample. Now we will wait for 10 to 15 minutes and see for any clumping of cells. Students, now you can see after waiting for 15 minutes, clumps have been formed on B side of slide. Whereas on comparing it on the opposite side, that is C, where we have used only blood, no clumping or agglutination has occurred. So what has we concluded? That the blood group of the person is Rh positive, that is, the antigens on the RBCs have reacted with the antibodies present in the reagent. So our conclusion is, the blood group of our subject is O positive.